Josh, thank you for taking time to talk to me today.
Hey, Matthew. Yeah, no problem, man. Thanks for having me.
Your film, Oh, Lucy, is in theaters today. From its opening scene, it grabbed me and didn't let go. How would you describe this film?
Yeah, it's an unusual film. It's difficult to describe. But it's, first of all, I want people to know that it's an incredibly entertaining film. And I think what you just said there in the description, your description of it, your experience of it, is what a lot of people have been surprised by, is that it's a comedy, but it's also very dramatic and tragic. And it's in Japanese, it's in English, set in Tokyo and in the States. Yes, there are subtitles for some of the film, but it's a really engaging film. And the other actors are all phenomenal actors, very well-known actors in Japan. And I'm the only native English-speaking American who plays one of the leads. And it's an unusual project to be a part of. But shortly, it's about an office worker in Tokyo, a woman who's very lonely and unhappy, who kind of gets conned into taking an English class by this basically unaccredited ne'er-do-well English teacher named John. And she falls in love with him, but then he moves back to the States, and she follows him to the States. And she lacks all social grace, and he's not much of a nice guy, and hilarity ensues. I don't know. That's the film. It's very bizarre.
Yeah, no. Oh, Lucy, it's awkward, it's funny, it's deeply emotional, and a lot of the credit needs to go towards the lead. How talented is Shinobu?
Shinobu's amazing. She's been one of Japan's favorite, like, most award-winning actors for the last few years. And she is from a family of really talented kabuki theater artists. So she grew up in that world, and she draws on that experience, the kabuki theater experience, in this role so much. The character doesn't necessarily say a lot, but you can tell exactly what she's thinking through each scene. And she's a phenomenally talented person, and it's a gift of a part. It's a fantastic part. A lot of the credit has to go to Atsuko as well, the director, Atsuko Hirayanagi, for creating such an endearing and difficult character for someone to play. Actually, for all of us, the characters are all somewhat mesmerizing in the fact that they're interesting. They're difficult people to love on paper, but they're drawn with empathy. I think that this director, Atsuko, is going to be, this is her first film. I think she's going to be somebody that people talk about quite a bit over the next few years.
And let's talk about, like, a little nuance of the film. The hug is a very big part of the movie. What do you think the symbolization is of the hug?
Well, I think it means something different to each culture, right? People just don't. That's not a big part of Japanese culture, especially for the generation that Lucy is supposed to be in. Her character's name, her actual name, is Setsuko. And so Setsuko comes from a place where you don't get a lot of physical contact like that. Whereas where John, my character, is from Southern California, a hug is the most natural thing in the world. Everybody's always hugging each other, kissing each other on the cheek. And that sort of demonstrative side has less weight. And so something that seems as simple as a handshake to John comes across as something romantic to our main character, Lucy, Oscar, Setsuko, and it sets off this series of events. So it's very significant and yet very goofy at the same time, which I think is the real heart of why this film works so well.
And in researching the film, I saw that in Japan, suicide is the leading cause of death in men aged 20 to 44. Atsuko doesn't pull any punches with this topic. Was her intentions to put a spotlight on the issue or create an empathetic friend for those that are hurting?
You know, you'd have to ask her. I've heard her respond to the question of suicide being a theme in her film, and I think that she said this is all just me, you know, trying to remember exactly the way she phrased it, so it's not from the horse's mouth. But I think that she said that she was, first of all, trying to illuminate these characters in the reality of their situation, and that is the reality of life in Tokyo and in Japan. And so suicide is very much a part of daily life, more so than it is here in the States. And she couldn't shy away from that. And it became a theme in the film, but it wasn't necessarily written from a political place, if you know what I mean.
Yeah.
It was written more from a human place. And this character said there, Atsuko has a story of who this character is to her personally. And, it's not for me to tell, but she was definitely trying to exercise some of the feelings that she has for a specific person in her life by drawing that character of Lucy.
And I saw in a previous interview that this is your eighth film working with a first-time director. Why is this so important?
Sounds about right. Because it's way more exhilarating. Working with first-time filmmakers can be really difficult, but it also can be insane, rewarding in ways that you've never experienced before. This film is so unlike anything else I've been a part of, and the experience of making it was so unlike anything else I've been a part of that I received 10 times the amount of sort of feeling back from it than I gave to it. It was just a rewarding experience from beginning to end. So sometimes it doesn't work out that way, but sometimes it does. So it's a high wire walking act, really, as opposed to walking down the street. You know, if you're doing a big blockbuster film and you're working with a director who's made 50 films, you have a pretty good idea of how that film's going to turn out, and you have a pretty good idea of how audiences are going to react to that film. And so there's a little bit less to gain. And when you do a film like this, you have no idea how it's going to come out, but you have a lot of hope. And when it does work out, it's really satisfying. I don't know. So I'm addicted to it.
And I mean, this isn't the traditional path of a Hollywood star. I mean, like, it's, you're bucking the trend. It's very fascinating. And I'm researching this. I enjoyed it a lot that this was the path that you're taking. And I mean, like, do you think about your colleagues? Are you trying to inspire others to take chances when you do things like this?
Sure. I'm not really thinking about inspiring anyone else. For me, it's like it's a gift. The fact that I'm allowed to go make a film like this is it's not something I would have expected from my life. And the fact that it takes me out of the zone of my life where I know what's going to happen is, it feels like I feel incredibly fortunate to have that opportunity. So in a way, I almost don't want anyone else to get excited about doing these films, because I want to keep them all for myself. Actually, since doing this film, I've been able to work with two other first-time directors. So I think that might bring the total up to 10. I don't know. I'd have to go back and check or think about it a little bit harder. I'm not sure off the top of my head.
I hopped on social media and I asked people to send me some questions in, and every question that came to me was, people want to know if you have a cameo in the new Halloween film.
They haven't asked me to be a part of it. So, no, I have no cameo in the new Halloween film.
Done. It's entered. Answered. And now that you're an older statesman of the industry, and you have a larger body of work behind you, are you still afraid a superhero role will define you?
No, I have no. It was a young man who had done probably 8 to 10 films at that point in my career, who was afraid that, and I think rightfully so, because it happened to some actors around that time, because superhero films were viewed differently at the time, that it would have the effect of sort of disallowing me the sort of choices that I'm making now. And so I decided not to be a part of that. But these days, everybody's working in superhero films, and superhero films are a different breed than they used to be. So, no, I'm not afraid of that definition anymore. At the same time, it would have to be the right sort of role. It would still have to be interesting to be a part of. You know, I wouldn't want to just play a role in a big-budget film, big superhero film, in order to play one. You know, I'd like it to be something that could be different in some way.
One last question. One of your other projects, The Long Home, has seen some delays. Is there any update on the James Franco film?
I don't know. Actually, I haven't spoken to James in a while, but I assume that it's coming out sometime this year. It's been a long time since I shot that film. It's been 2.5 years, maybe. But I've got 4 other films that I've shot over the last year that are going to come out. And yeah, I'm surprised as anybody that hasn't come out yet, because it was shot so long ago. Yeah, sorry. No updates for me.
No problem. Josh, thank you for your time, and best of luck with all your projects.
Appreciate it. Thank you very much. Thanks for having me.